Hello and welcome to PDFSupply.com. Today we're going to be testing an RX3i analog input card. I have here an IC694ALG222. This card is capable of reading from negative to positive 10 volts DC, that's the range. And what else is special about it is you can either choose from 16 channel single-ended voltage current voltage DC inputs or 8 differential voltage DC inputs. Okay, so it's 16 or 8 depending on what your purpose is, what you're using it for. And there are two different wiring diagrams that go along with that. All right, so a couple things about this controller, this particular card, is that when you have the system powered up the way that you see it here, you should have a module OK light on. All right, when it goes through the self-diagnostic, it should be green here, or at least blinking green, but green. If you don't have any light on, then that means that there's some sort of problem with the card immediately, and that you'll need to either replace it or repair it. Okay. Second thing is very important. I'm using an IC695CHS007 slot rack. You can use a 012 slot rack or a 016 slot rack. Whichever it is that you choose to use, you need to know that this other LED that appears here, that this is the module power supply that powers up this individual unit, needs to come from an outside source, and it needs to be connected to the 7 slot rack. Okay, so on the far left hand side of the rack, you'll notice something that's labeled TB, and on the bottom two screws of that terminal strip on the rack, on the chassis, is the inputs for your positive and negative leads from an external 24 volt power supply. Okay, very important, you must have this in order to do this test. So my negative lead is in the bottom most screw from the 24 volt power supply, and my positive lead is in the second to the last screw on that 24 volt power supply. And I'm going to go ahead and power that up right now so you can see. Once that is on, once you got 24 volts going through there, you should have this light on. So before you start the test, make sure that you have both lights on and that this is working properly. Otherwise, you won't be able to follow the test. Okay, now that I have everything in there physically, we're going to go over to the software and do some configuration. I'm using Proficy Machine Edition. We're going to go to the navigator bar and rack 0. Okay, as you can see, it's my CHS007, as I mentioned. My power supply is using two slots, slot 0 and slot 1. And my processor is using two slots as well, slot 2 and slot 3. And that leaves me with the next available slot, number 4. Okay, now you can either double click or right click on slot 4, add module, analog input, and as we said before, it's an IC694ALG222. Okay. So the configuration here, a couple things that you need to know. There's the different modes that you can select from, differential or single-ended, depending on if it's a 8 or 16 channel. And the amount of active channels. Okay, you can see this is italicized here. This is an important one. The range, of course, as you can see, it says editable range variable 1 to 16. So we're going to make this 16. We're going to check all 16 channels. Next thing is if you choose to change the values from either 0 to 10 volt DC positive or negative 10 volt to positive 10 volt DC, you can do so here. Okay, you can make that change. For our test, we're just going to do 0 to 10 volt DC. Now, another quick note I wanted to mention about what exactly you're going to be probing these channels with. That's up to you. As long as you have a 10 volt DC source or a source that some sort of a power supply that can give you 10 volts DC, or even a variable range from 0 to 10 volt DC would be better. If you have something more sophisticated where you can actually do the negative 10 to positive 10, that's great too. What I usually use is I have a memory battery that supplies 3 volts DC positive, and I have a negative and a positive lead coming from the battery. Now, the reason I use, I have a few reasons that I use this. One is I like that it's in, kind of in the lower middle of the range. So when I probe it, it's giving me three things. It's one, it's going to tell me whether the channel is a good working active channel or not, just by giving me a reading to begin with. Second thing it's going to do is it's going to give me, it will let me know if the circuit is stable. Because I know that the voltage coming out of this battery is stable. I know it's not going to go up or down. And I need to see that the input card is coming to the same conclusion, that it's also seeing that it's not fluctuating. All right, so if you have a fluctuating channel, that means that you have a problem with that circuit. The other thing is it should read is somewhere in the range of what would be the equivalent in the scaling of 3 volts. Okay, my scaling goes from 0 to 32,000, but the reason that I say that is because a lot of times with analog input, we notice that they fail at full value, or occasionally they fail at full value, not every time. And that means that you could probe it with 2 volts, it's going to tell you it's got 10 volts, or you know, it's going to tell you that you have a value of 32,000. No matter what voltage you put to it, it's immediately and always going to tell you you have 32,000. That's a failed circuit. So, three things that you need to look out for: stability, an active channel, and a failed circuit based on it failing at full value. All right, so now that we have that out of the way, we're going to hit the lightning bolt icon and connect up to the processor. And then we're going to toggle online by hitting the green handprint. Now, I need to show you down below, if you follow my arrow, this is the status bar. It's in programmer mode. It's stop disabled, which means that it's not in run mode and the outputs are disabled. And the configuration is not equal. And it probably should say that the logic is not equal as well. But what that's telling you is that it's technically faulted right now. It's telling you that the processor was doing a different function before you've asked it to test this ALG222. So it is faulted. We're going to go to target. Online commands, clear. And we're going to clear the controller and the I/O fault tables. All right, very important. Make sure that you do those two. You don't have to do anything further than that. And then we're going to hit download and run, or download and start active target. Make sure that you do the clearing process as you just saw me do. Otherwise, you're going to get hung up during this build, this download. We only want to do hardware configuration, motion, and logic. There's no need to write anything to permanent flash memory or force values. So we'll hit OK. All right, now, when this finishes up, the next thing that we're going to do is we're going to go to our default tables. And we're going to look for the address of 00001, analog input 00001. Here we go. Now, output's enabled, yes. You can see our configuration and our logic are now equal, and we're in run mode. If for some reason that your configuration or logic are not equal, or you're not in run mode, go to your feedback zone, which mine is right here, and find out what the problem is. Also, double check to make sure that if you open up the battery door to your CPU, make sure that the run button or the I/O enabled button is in the far right hand position. Okay, it's a switch from left to right. Should be in the far right position. Sometimes that'll hang you up. Now we'll go down to, if you look at your settings, our reference address, our first channel is going to be on 00001, analog input table. And here's our address. You can see my arrow hovering over it, and it's giving me an illumination that says analog input 00001. Now, according to the wiring diagram, I'm going to plant my negative lead on terminal number 19, that's the bottom left-hand side. And to agitate channel number one, I'm gonna put my lead, positive lead that is, on terminal number three. Okay. Now, based on a scale value of maximum scale value of 32,000, 3 volts should be somewhere in the neighborhood, give or take, of 10,000. So I got 9,736. But it's a fairly stable, solid range that I'm in. Very, very close. Okay. All channels are looking the same. Now you go left and right in a zigzagging pattern. I'm now on terminal number four, which is channel number two. Then I'm going to go back to the left-hand side of the terminal and go back and forth. Pay attention to the wiring diagram. Now I'm going to go through one by one, of course, and test each circuit to make sure that they're all working, left and right, all 16. Okay, so I'm going to stop right there so you guys understand the pattern. And if for some reason we're going to switch back over to the ALG222 tab, we're going to stop the controller. If for any reason that you guys want to use the differential version, which is the other wiring diagram that gives you 8 channels, you can do so. And you can see we're in red here. That means that we're faulted. And select 8 channels. And now we're in differential mode. So you would go through the same exact process. We're going to be, our configuration is not equal because we're asking it to do something slightly different, different amount of channels. You'd of course go to target online commands and clear those faults. Go through your download process once more, open up your analog input table, and follow the wiring diagram that tells you where to put your positive and negative leads on the 8-channel differential mode. Okay, same thing, the 8-channel differential mode has the ability to do negative or positive 10 volts DC. One easy way to do a negative 10 volts DC is obviously just to switch your polarities on the power source that you're using. In other words, making your common, which is terminal screw number 19, your positive lead rather than your negative lead. Okay, hope that makes sense. But that's pretty much the entire test. Just as a quick recap, make sure that your lights are working properly on the module itself when it's powered up and when the rack is given the external 24 volt DC power supply. Yeah, remember to use that 24 volt DC power supply on the CHS007 or 16 or 12 chassis that you happen to be using. And check for circuits that are, number one, working and giving you any kind of reading or some sort of reading. Make sure that the reading is as stable as possible. And make sure that the circuit is not giving you a feedback of full value immediately. Again, that could be a failed circuit. So any of those things could be a problem with this ALG222. And it would need replacement or repair. Okay, that's how you can tell the difference. So if that's something that you need or interests you, we offer exchange programs, new and remanufactured products, and you can find us at pdfsupply.com. Thank you.